Anybody heard that before?
Sure.
This is an old song.
It's not the TV station, is it?
No. Newscast, yes, no. Okay.
Thank you. 15 or 16 Irish songs. And he said, we ought to work this up and try to do it at the library. So this is what has come out of that.
It's quite
This is a song about the Irish potato famine. And 1845 to 1850, Martin's going to do it. And it, the death toll in Ireland at the time was about 25% between people dying off and those that fled the country, fled the country. So that's what we have here. It's bad.
Scotch Irish, except for us. local.
I'm the outsider, yeah.
Well, actually, Danish goes with that.
Yeah, they were. Danes don't have these kinds of songs, so I heard you just wrote them.
Okay, well, this next song we're going to do for you is Fiddle Me Down in the ODA. This is basically an old Irish immigrant came across, and the only work he could find was on the railroad. So, yes, he's talking about what happened on the railroad and how he met his wife, and then how he lost his wife. It's sad at the end, but most Irish songs are. So. Fill me over the ODA.
It's a fun song.
We do the chorus to start. Is that what you're doing? Okay.
I mean, more than usual. We need help clapping. There's the first line of the chorus goes, "It's no name number," and I need for you to clap four times because our hands are usually kind of busy. So just more fun than a poker.
I know. recruit 30,000, send them off to Ireland to keep order, to keep the Republican Army down, Irish Republican Army down. So what they became is kind of thugs, and they were really brutal. They would hang you. If you could be just accused of something, they would drag you out and have hangings in the street. And they searched houses. But anyhow, down at the southern part of Ireland, in a little town, called Kilashandra, a bunch of Irish farmers had had enough, so they kind of ambushed the company of these black and tans and killed about 20 of them. And of course, it got back, it got in the press, and they finally did away with the black and tans, and they put the regular English troops in Ireland, which were a little bitter. They weren't so abusive. But this is the song about the Irish farmers beating the black and tans. So yeah, a little bit of history.
Thicker the more it drinks that water.
Yes.
Yeah.
You wonder what's in that water. Go ahead, Ben.
Oh, this is just Go Lassie Go. It's an old Scottish song written in the 1700s, and it's been around a long time.
We're in the second fret, I hope. Make a difference.
Only just somebody's listening.
Yeah, it's usually mother singing.
So Thank you.
1999 in Dublin, they commissioned and actually did a bronze statue, full-size bronze statue of Molly Malone. She died 300 years earlier in 1699, and it's actually probably one of the more famous things that Dublin is famous for, so they started to have a statue up.
So,
no, I'm trying to put some into it, but I couldn't even. You know what I was thinking about? We was driving down Randall here, and Martine said, "Where did that statue come from?" And I just caught a glimpse out of the corner. What's the statue down here? You just come off the interstate, and there's a statue there. But who's that up now? Have you seen that? I'm thinking it's new. I don't know. I haven't seen it.
This one's the same.
Okay, this all three?
Sure. In Dublin's fair city, where the girls are so pretty,
I'm It's not
It just means twilight, that really kind of magical time of day.